It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Saints and the Hawks coming up next.
We are in the Pacific Northwest as we get set for football at Lumen Field in the Southern District of Seattle.
This crowd, as we've come to expect in recent years, as loud as any in the NFL, and they get even louder when their Seahawks are introduced. We're ready for football as the Seahawks get set to do battle with the New Orleans Saints.
Brandon Gordon alongside the one and only Charles Davis. And CD, lots of compelling storylines in a game like this. Let's take a look at some of the numbers for these two offenses.
And I'm glad you brought up the numbers, because sometimes it's hard to quantify a team's performance solely by judging the numbers. But I think with these two teams, what you see is a pretty accurate representation of who they are.
Kickoff, it'll come out to the 25. Seattle's offense ready to go here for the first time, and leading them is the 7-time Pro Bowler in his 10th year now in the NFL, Russell Wilson.
Gave the commencement address at the University of Wisconsin a couple of years ago. One of the most popular players ever to pull on the uniform there. Beginning of his career, he was a so-called game manager. Take care of the football and rely on the defense. Now, in this stage of his career, the offense runs through him, and it runs very well.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Steps away to his left. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there will be designed runs as well as his scrambles.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Throwing is Wilson, rolling to his right. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Now Wilson on first down. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
But normally you see 3 tight ends in a formation, you have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run, and I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or 2 towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already in the field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. Throwing again here, Wilson forced out to his left. Working the middle here, that's complete to Everett, the tight end. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout as there's a Saints player down here on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Here's Wilson, eluding the pressure right. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down.
And that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down, and inside the 5 yard line.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Now it's Wilson. Steps away. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Will Disley, the intended receiver, but it'll be second and goal.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what off?
And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. Russell Wilson keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Seahawks take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. They gotta love that. 9-play drive results in 6 points.
That means they're doing the dictating. That means that they've described how the game's going to go. They're playing at their tempo, at their pace. If you're on the other side of the ball, if you're playing defense, defense is not methodical. They've got to go in there and shake things up and create a little havoc.
Jason Myers now for the extra point. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it was Russell Wilson finishing things off with a touchdown run. Turn man. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. First drive coming up here for this New Orleans Saints offense. And leading about a quarterback here in 2021 in his 7th NFL season, it's Jameis Winston.
This is a big change for everyone in the Bayou country because Drew Brees is no longer the starting quarterback, so there'll be a new starter for the first time since 2006 for the Saints. Jameis Winston, as we all know, unlimited potential, has a 5,100-yard season on his resume in Tampa. But turnovers, that's the biggest part. He's got to change. If he does that, he could take the reins and really run with them in New Orleans.
Tackled by Darrell Taylor. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10. Jameis to throw it. On the check down, he finds Kamara. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12.
I believe I could see what they were trying to do there, but unfortunately, the back ran out of room, too close to the sideline. And for defenders, we're often taught, 11 on the field, those sidelines can become the 12th defender. It worked to the defense's advantage on that play.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on 3rd down. Winston. Buying time to his left. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down.
And they had an extra defensive back on the field on that play, and the coverage was excellent. He tried to pull it down and run for it, but they rallied to him and kept him short of a first down.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Taken in at the 22. It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. And he's been fun to watch run the football. We know he can pass, but using his legs effectively here in this one.
No doubt about it. Watch him maneuver in the pocket, out of the pocket, making the plays that he's making, which are breaking down the defense. I thought back to when we had our morning jog before the game, and I couldn't keep up with you. Those legs, they're valuable for his team.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say, when you run into big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now. Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Wilson now off the bootleg. That's complete into the hands of Carson. They should have got more out of that, though. He was wide open.
I love how emphatic you are with that call, because that's exactly what I was thinking. Wide open in the flat. Give him a ball that he can use to get upfield with, not just catch and go over the sideline. They cost themselves some yardage there.
They go play action with Wilson. He lets it fly for Lockett. And this is caught, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett, 60 yards. And the Seahawks have taken a 13-0 first quarter lead. Well, you normally talk about the mobility and the accuracy first, but the arm strength, that's what can turn Russ into danger, Russ.
And that is absolutely demoralizing for a defense, because you've got the offense on the ropes, it's third down, you're trying to get off the field, and then wham, you have a letdown in the secondary, and you give up a big one.
And that throw, wow, 72 yards in the air, according to Next Gen Stats. Myers connects on the PAT, and that'll make the score 14-0. Scoring summary, 3-play drive, and it all culminates with a Seattle score. Touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Callaway, the return man. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The New Orleans Saints coming back out here on offense. And Charles, how strange week one will it be? But for the first time since 2005, Drew Brees will not be under center. Jameis Winston named the starter. What did you make of that decision? And where do you see the Saints going in the post-Drew Brees era?
Wasn't surprised at all by the decision. If Jameis Winston played well during the preseason, absorbed the coaching from Sean Payton and his staff, took care of the football, and he did all those things, and showed the ability to throw the ball downfield, which has always been his specialty. So that's an added dimension to this offense that they haven't had in the last few seasons. They expect to expand it. Taysom Hill, he'll probably go back and do a number of things now, in addition to playing some quarterback at times. But for the Saints, their defense is very proud, and they think they can help carry this football team. Cameron Jordan at defensive end, DeMario Davis at linebacker, Marshawn Lattimore at corner. They think that they can contend, not just for the NFC South, they are burning to get back to a Super Bowl.
And remember, unfortunately, because of Hurricane Ida and the destruction in New Orleans, the Saints will start by playing in Jacksonville. They're not sure how long they will have to wait before returning home, but they'll start the season by playing their quote-unquote home game in Jacksonville. Well, on first down, they run with Kamara. He'll take it forward for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. Jordan Brooks on the tackle. From the 45 on second down, Winston will find its tight end. It's Adam Troutman. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 39.
And the Saints not only missing Drew Brees from last year, they also lost their top tight end, Jared Cook, to the Chargers. So tight end, it's a position in flux. But that's a nice grab there to pick up the first down.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Throwing, Winston. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. They go play action. Winston. Flush to his right. Man open, it's Chris Hogan. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 15-yard line. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, Winston. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up second down. Jameis again. And he's got it.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal.
They're right there at the 1. No gain, but don't let that stop you. Line back up and keep going at him. If I'm them, I'm thinking about going at it 4 straight times.
Again, Kamara. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
This has not been a fun sequence for him at all. First and goal, no gain. Second and goal, he ends up losing yardage. He may be trying to talk him into getting the ball third time, but I think it's going to be difficult for him to win that battle.
This Seattle defense, they haven't broken yet. Coming up here on a third and goal situation. Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? Oh, Montgomery just unable to twist free as they hit him short of the line to gain. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Throw
Osa's kick is good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3.
So a long drive gets them down inside the five, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the three, and I think it was a smart move.
Reed going to bring it out of the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback.
But Charles, these Seattle Seahawks, as they get ready here for their next drive, they're a team that, I don't know, I really haven't heard a whole lot about in the offseason. Maybe that's a good thing. 12-4 last year, they won the NFC West for the first time since 2016, but then they lost to the Rams in the wild card round. But what are you hearing about Seattle and the prognostication for this upcoming campaign?
Well, Brandon, they've got a brand new offensive coordinator who came from division rival Rams, and they expect this offense to take another leap. DK Metcalf and Tyler Lockett out wide. They get Chris Carson back full-time at running back. Russell Wilson, of course, is Russell Wilson. And they start playing a little bit better on defense, and they were starting to do that the second half of last season. The Seahawks team will once again be dangerous, but what a division. The Rams, the 49ers, the Cardinals. Wow, that's a tough division. But the Seahawks won it last year. They expect to be in that mix again this season.
And they'll open their season on the road in Indianapolis week one.
And he is going to have a Seahawks first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd-and-3.
Well, Carter, know these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
So from the 36 now, 1st-and-10. They run the counter. It's Carson, and he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. And the tackle there by Quan Alexander.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. Three-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on 4th down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That 2nd down play, that's a -4. Wilson after the play fake to Carson, being chased out left. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh 7 downs.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a 1st down.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st-and-10.
Off the play fake, here's Wilson. He hits his target, Lockett. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. It's a gain of 35.
Boy, they've definitely come out of the gate smoking here in the first quarter. Whatever they've tried to run has worked. And there's another example right there. Game plan is one thing, but how about his accuracy? It's been exceptional.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on 1st-and-10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This is caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another 1st down.
And Gerald Everett makes a good catch there for a 1st down, and he was signed away from the Seattle Seahawks division rivals, the Rams, after 4 years in L.A. backing up Tyler Higbee. He's excited about his opportunity in the Pacific Northwest. Last year, 41 catches, a career high.
They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start.
Play action. Now Wilson. escaping the pressure right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
On second and goal, Wilson. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the four-yard line. It's a loss of four. Now third down. When you throw it this close to the goal line, usually you're thinking touchdown. Here they actually complete it but lose yardage.
When you're this close to the goal line, you have to anticipate that maybe you're going to see a defense that you can make a case that there's 11 in the box. There's just no room. So I'm with you. You've got to find a way to push.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Russell Wilson with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
The extra point now coming from Myers. And it's 21-3. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it was Russell Wilson finishing things off with a touchdown run. Turn man, and able to get this out to the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
21-3 is your score after one. The Saints with a football here to begin quarter number two, as they've got it with a second and one coming up. Now Winston. It's brought in by Harris. First connection there of the afternoon for those two, and it's good for a first down.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Winston to give, it's Kamara. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. To throw is Winston. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And it's third down.
We've already seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball in the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
I know I spend a lot of time talking about tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to the ground. It's Kamara. Just a yard on the pickup there. That'll bring up a second and 9. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Marquez Cattaway, 42 yards. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Aldrick Rosas on for the extra point. It's up and good, and the lead is down now at 11. It's 21-10. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in 7 plays, and it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. This is DJ Reed returning. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. Here's Russell Wilson and the Seahawk offense now getting set to go again. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
From the 44, Wilson. Throw left side, complete. That's Carson. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Here's Carson. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
From the 45 on 2nd down, Wilson, pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Cameron Jordan wreaking havoc with a sack.
And this is a quarterback who's already had success on the ground in this first half, but this time they're able to hem him in.
And it's always different when you rush a mobile quarterback as opposed to a guy you know will be right back in the pocket. In this case, you got to make sure the inside pressure and the outside pressure match, and maybe even a second wave to make sure if he squirts free, you've got someone to tackle him.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's 3rd and long here. They go play action now. Wilson. Under pressure, they got him again. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack.
An offensive line play and pass protection has been a problem in recent years for the Seahawks. And more importantly, for quarterback Russell Wilson. They allowed 48 sacks last year, the 5th most in the NFL. They vowed to improve. Didn't get it done on that play.
On 4th down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. Deontay Harris deep for New Orleans. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10.
New Orleans offense back out and ready to go.
I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Winston now to throw on first down. And he's got his target, Harris. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 25 yards that time.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
On second down, Kamara. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
On third down, Winston.
Throw left side complete to Troutman.
And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
I thought maybe when he caught it, he'd have a good chance of getting that first down, but that's a nice job of holding him up and preventing him from getting to the sticks.
Here comes the Saints punter now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
They'll start out on the ground with Carson. Carson, the first down and more. And he'll get this all the way up to the 42-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down. That run successful in large part because they had a lot of extra help blocking up front.
Yeah, you've got guys who can do that very, very well. In addition, they can catch the football. So sometimes when they line up with three tight ends, it's not necessarily to run it, and that gives you an advantage when you do decide to barrel off the line of scrimmage and block people downfield.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. This is Carson. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 48 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 43. They run it with Carson. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Second and six. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Now it's Carson. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
On this drive so far, it's first and 10. Now a toss play. It's Carson, and he'll get about three as he's brought down to the 28.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3 yard gain.
Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The Seahawks on third down. They've been excellent, 6 for 7. This will be third and 6. Now a handoff here to his running back. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Draw play. This is Carson. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. Following the pickup of four, here's second and 6. On the delay, here's Carson. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 and the 6. 86 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
Play action, it's Wilson. Left side complete to Lockett. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Not much there, only a yard. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Wilson. Flushed out right. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
Myers' kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So a nice kick there as they were able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away.
No return there for Harris. And the drive will begin at the 25. Time again to see Jameis Winston in this Saints offense.
A lot of the problems have been on the other side of the ball. Is that frustrating for a quarterback who's been playing well?
It is, but there's no way that the best ones let their teammates know that. They actually take it upon themselves and say, okay, I have to do even more, or I need to play better. Maybe even say, I put my defense in a bad spot. That's what true leadership shows you.
Yeah, well, he doesn't need to change much personally. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. To throw once more on second and 10. Winston,
he'll get this to his tight end, Troutman.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Jameis to throw it.
Open man complete to Humphrey.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play. I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. First down, Winston. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Well, it's time to give more credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. They'll throw again. Winston. He gets it complete to Harris.
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A third down conversion with a strong gain of 14.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
On first and 10, Winston. And his throw is incomplete. The former Bill, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And it's second down. Throwing, Winston. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. L.J. Collier in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. Here comes the Saints punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead, but that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game, but we probably should go to the post-game press conference, because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points,
but
and we
wasn't?
Know that's not true.
Yeah.
Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
Now this throw caught left side, and he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. Wilson to lock it there for the Seahawks first down.
And that guy just keeps getting better. And I'm talking about Tyler Lockett, who just made that nice catch there for a first down. Now in his seventh season with Seattle, last year may have been his finest yet. And even 100 catches, many of them of the spectacular variety. Paired with DK Metcalf, a heck of a dynamic duo for the Seahawks.
Now Wilson on first down. And he fires one that's intercepted. P.J. Williams with a pick. And they're going to be set up in the end zone right around the 17-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Jameis, Winston, and company heading back onto the field now. And how does he rally the troops, so to speak? He's played well, but they're down big on the scoreboard. How does he get his guys going?
To make sure they understand it's not a me game, it's a team game. Everyone has to come together. Everyone has to up the level of play a little bit, including himself, and find a way to make some plays in order to give them a little bit of a spark and rally the team.
We'll see if they can indeed rally down big on the scoreboard right now. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call, mark off the five, and keep it moving.
Now Winston. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Rosas now to add the PAT. He's got it, and it's 24-17. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score it. Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. Here's Reed. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Tyler Lockett trotting onto the field, getting set for this next drive. Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but he's shredding defense, is getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Dancing to his left. It's caught. Lockett. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1. Second down at 4. Throwing is Wilson. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. Dwayne Eskridge, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 4. Now Wilson, out to his left. Fighting his way through contact and taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. On 1st and 10, it's Wilson.
And this will go to Carson out wide.
And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. So we are at halftime here in downtown Seattle with the Seahawks out in front. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. We saw a strong first half out of quarterback Russell Wilson. First things first, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Saints. And they've had plenty of success throwing the football so far this afternoon, as they're on pace to throw for over 300 yards if their form holds. Meanwhile, for the Seahawks, we check out their numbers on the ground as they'll try to keep the momentum going into the second half. With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime, but the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter 3? Callaway, the return man. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Winston and the Saints now with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule.
Not too many more ideal situations at 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Running with Kamara. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Bobby Wagner, the all-pro, in on the tackle. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
A give. This is Kamara. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
44 yards on the ground for him so far.
So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down, Terry.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down.
Darryl Taylor drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down.
Every now and then, you just absolutely outguess yourself. Third and inches, and they decide not to run the ball. You end up seeing the end result.
The end result was not good. They elect to pass, and it backfires. Here comes the Saints punter now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Taken in at the 11. Yeah, very good return that time. 18 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here comes the Seahawks offensive unit. They'll have it first to begin the third. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now, first and 10, right at the 30. Now Wilson, rolling to his left. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The linebacker, DeMario Davis, got a hand in to break that one up.
Well, CD, something that we've done for a number of years as the season gets going is we get predictions on each side. Let's start with the AFC. Who do you have in 2021 as your division winners?
Well, let's go to the East, and I think Buffalo repeats, although New England, they got better in the offseason, and despite starting a rookie quarterback in Mac Jones, I think they'll make a nice run in the Buffalo Bills this year. In the North, what a battle you have there. Three-way. Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Baltimore. I like Baltimore to still win the division, but Cleveland will be right there, and Pittsburgh will make a run at the playoffs. In the South, I think it's Tennessee's division to lose. Indianapolis had a number of injuries in the offseason, and, you know, Jacksonville and Houston, they're trying to get there. And then out West, it's still Kansas City. But I love what the Los Angeles Chargers have done in the offseason.
All right, CD, and then if you had to pick, who do you have winning the AFC?
Well, I'm going to go against type here, Brandon, because teams aren't supposed to sustain as long as the Kansas City Chiefs have. But despite a retooled offensive line, I do think that they get back there again. What happened to them in the Super Bowl against Tampa Bay, that serves as great motivation. They want to get back and atone themselves.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now it's Wilson on the move to his left. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And that'll bring up second down.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds a defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback, I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Tyler Lockett was the target there, and it'll bring up third down. Wilson dumps this one off to Chris Carson, and he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Wilson and the offense not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Steps away to his left. And this one is incomplete. Pete Carroll rolled the dice, but it didn't work out. And the Saints will have the football back.
Hey, let's go back, Charles, to your preseason predictions. You gave us what you thought on the AFC. How about the NFC side in 2021?
All right, how about the Washington football team winning the NFC East? I think in the North, Green Bay comes back and represents again. In the South, Tampa Bay, who finished second in their division last year to New Orleans, they win the division this time. And then out West, the Los Angeles Rams with their new quarterback, Matthew Stafford.
And I like that. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not.
He was really focused downfield, but there was really no viable options. The coverage was too good.
And the defense really quickened the tempo of that play with their pass rush because there was nowhere for him to go with the football. The only place he ended up, down on the ground.
Second and 12.
Another try after the first down sack. Winston. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. Brings up third down. Winston from the gun on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. Had to pass there. Third and long on your own side of the field. Just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for third and short, because when it's third and long, the odds go down significantly trying to pick up the first down, even throwing the football.
And this will be taken at the 13. Work on the run back there, 33 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
Out comes Chris Carson in the Seattle offense.
And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Called on a very strong gain of 24.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Wilson. Steps away. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end Everett. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down.
I tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. The linebacker, DeMario Davis, got a hand in to break that one up. On second and 10, Wilson, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Marcus Davenport picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Now, the number one mission of any offensive line, you got to protect that quarterback, keep him safe back there. This time, the rush got to him in a hurry.
And it appears that this was just a letdown from the offensive line, but they do have a tough job because if you're a big tackle out there on the perimeter, sometimes you don't have the agility to keep up with the defensive end who's looking to wreak havoc in the backfield, and he got there and put his man on the ground.
Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Forced out to his left.
And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. Able to find a lot of empty space there, picking up the first down at a 21-yard gain.
These type of plays are backbreakers for our defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Carson. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
Carson again. And he's across the chalk, into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. Chris Carson, a three-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks add on to their lead.
Just power football there, down near the goal line. Give it to him, he's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Now Myers for the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. So that drives seven plays in length. And it was all capped off by the Chris Carson touchdown run.
Turn man. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Looking deep downfield. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
You definitely would have liked to have hit on that one, because now you've got a third and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to be getting after it. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
And open here is Hogan. He's got it. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a third and 18.
So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
To the air again with Winston. Eluding. And Winston lost the football. And the Seahawks have recovered.
We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side. A little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you are closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Cameron Jordan able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
A CD, a little bit of feast or famine for him. He's had some success throwing the football, but also now he's been sacked four times.
Yeah, you just mentioned the four sacks, but you're right. He has managed to hang in there and make plays at times. His offensive line, they've got to figure it out and pick things up and give him more opportunities, and he has to help them by getting rid of the ball a little bit quicker as well.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams.
Certainly not his best throw that time, and not a good time to make it, Charles, when they were a nickel with five defensive backs on the field.
And that's exactly why you have those five DBs out there. You want extra speed on the field, guys who have ball skills and understand what the passing game can do, and gives them a chance to react and make a play on the football, and they take one of those away.
Winston and the Saints now with a first and 10 at the 31-yard line. And he'll start with a give to Kamara.
And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Jameis to throw it. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawks defense. Benson Mayoa drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be fourth and long.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Here comes the Saints punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Taken from just outside the 30. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they've made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
Have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing him all sorts of trouble.
But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Here's Wilson. Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Cameron Jordan able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing a big way, and what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down, that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. Cameron Jordan, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
I don't know what else can be said about this pass rush. They have been sensational. CD, that is now six sacks for them.
And how many times do we talk to offensive coordinators and they say a sack is a result of everyone on offense not doing their job? But let's be honest about this one. This is the offensive line unable to counter the pass rush. They've been teeing off all game long.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson under pressure, and they got to him again. Cameron Jordan, my goodness, make that now five sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Cameron Jordan in there to get him again. That is sack number six, one off the NFL record of seven.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. Now a fair catch is called for and taken a few yards across midfield. That'll go in the books as just a 16-yard punt. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A throw left side to start out. That's complete. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. 3 yards the gain there, second down. A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Seahawks 44. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's the Saints who hold the football, but they're trailing as we begin the fourth quarter of play. On third and one, here's Winston. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. And finally taken down at the 20-yard line. Forget the run on third and one. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. From the red zone now, Winston. Buying time to his left. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a hole. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. Here's Winston. That's complete to Troutman right side. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7.
They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. Working out of the gun, Winston. Got a man and he hits him in stride. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of five.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Kamara
hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And the offense is able to pounce on it inside the five-yard line.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Jamal Adams on the safety blitz, too fast to handle.
It has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now five sacks.
How'd you like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush? What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result on the scoreboard. Long day in the pocket for their quarterback.
Rosa's kick is good.
Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that. And this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
Here's Reed returning. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
A nice burst there as he'll get about seven that time on the first down run.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's going to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brent, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now, and here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up. Now it's Wilson. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And that one results in 35 yards.
Frankly, I don't know that this defense knows what to do anymore. Just look at their body language out there. The passing game has absolutely been relentless throughout.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. There's Wilson to throw. Out to his left. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Metcalf once again the target, and now it's second down.
Well, I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion, but this time the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Being chased out left. He hits his target, Lockett, and he's brought down after a very nice gain. The play began back at the 23, and they pick up 23.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Play action. Now Wilson rolling to his left. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Second down and goal. Wilson, he'll buy some time right. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Russell Wilson. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Seahawks have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. I've heard you use the term put away drive, and that right there seemed like the definition of a put away drive.
Yeah, it certainly just pops right up out of the book, doesn't it? Because up two scores already, just wanted to possess the football, keep converting and picking up first downs. And if the drive ends in 3 points, that's terrific. If it ends in a touchdown, fantastic.
Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead is up to 18 now. Touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. On the return, Deontay Harris. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now. I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Bobby Wagner, multiple times an All-Pro, in there to drop him for a loss. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Winston. Room to run past midfield. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Give him 30 yards there.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. To throw, Winston. Flush to his right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Throwing again on second down. Winston throwing the out route incomplete. That's Hogan. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. Winston. Touchdown! Marquez Callaway. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Saints have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th.
So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Rosas to add the extra point. And that one makes this an 11-point deficit now. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. Here's Reed. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. Chris Carson trotting back out there.
He's toppled the century mark already receiving the football, closing in on that on the ground, too. They've really had trouble handling him.
I think from what we've seen in this game, his success through the air has started to open things up for him on the ground, because now he's loosened up the defense, right? They've got to play just about every snap as if another receiver can get downfield on them, and he's been that receiver. Now they bring him back to the backfield. I think his yardage running the ball will increase as this one goes on.
Well, they might need to devote some extra attention to him, something just to stop the momentum he has. A gain of 6 there on first.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Well, there's Lockett pulling in a tough ground. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A Seahawk first down as Wilson finds Lockett. They go play action with Wilson. Pressure comes and Wilson's gonna go down. Marcus Davenport getting him once again, his 3rd sack of the afternoon.
Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, 4th quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. The New Orleans offense set to take over. Well, still a long way to go, but trending upward. They scored the last time out, you remember. Then their defense forced the punt. Now they try to inch closer, but still ultimately down 2 scores in the final quarter. Winston and the Saints now with a 1st and 10 at about the 32. Now Winston. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down. Now Winston. Flushed out right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the 1st down. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. Jameis now on 1st down. That's complete over the middle to Callaway. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. He'll get 15 and a Saints 1st down.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores. and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Winston. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara.
So many screen passes are the result of excellent acting by everyone, but sometimes the guy who's getting the ball tips the play off. The running back, because he's eager to get the pass, and sometimes he doesn't act very well about whether he's going to block or leak out or whatever. And I think that they saw that, and that's why they're able to get to him on it.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Here's Winston. This ball tipped and it's going to be incomplete. Fortunate maybe to get that back. It's third down. Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10. They'll throw again. Winston. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Harris. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. Sean Payton not liking that last call. He's going to go ahead and challenge it. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. The thing that they'll be looking at is a spot of the football, and this is always such a tough one for officials to get exactly right.
Not just because of how fast the game's going, but just trying to get the right sight line to the football. That's not always easy. We'll see what they decide here.
So you knew one way or another that they needed the two scores. They get the easy one out of the way. Now they'll get the ball back, hopefully.
Yeah, and the question is, how do you accomplish that? Do you onside kick it? Or since you have all three timeouts, do you kick it deep? To me, I'm playing field position with all three timeouts. I kick it deep and try and pin them back there.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Seattle again getting ready to take over offensively. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
They'll start by running the option to the right. And he powers his way up past the 30. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And tackled down after a gain of three leaves them with 1 yard to go on third down. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Throwing now is Wilson. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Winston and the Saints now down by 8. A little over a minute and a half remaining. They need a touchdown and, of course, the 2-point conversion as well. Now Winston. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. Adam Troutman, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Here's Winston. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Winston to throw.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. This defense looking impenetrable now. Three straight incompletions. They're giving him nowhere to go with the football. Maybe a little frustrated back there.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When you've missed on three straight, there's going to be some frustration. But now he's got to make sure that that frustration is temporary, not lingering. Big throw coming up.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. Oh, Wilson going to throw. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. Now Wilson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
New Orleans offense back out and ready to go. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
They have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Winston. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
He's going to let it fly. Oh, wide open, complete. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. An excellent pick up at 34 yards.
Well, if you're a fan of offensive football, this game is for you because this one's been much more like a tennis match than a football game. Back and forth, back and forth. And there's another example right there of another big play in the passing game.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. He'll look to throw. That is caught by Callaway. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Last play went for over 30 yards. This one not quite as big, but still over 20. And it's caught. Well, no doubt an electrifying finish to have it down inside the 10-yard line. That final shot, though, they couldn't get it in the end zone, and that's all she wrote.
And they had the final shot. The last snap taken that close to the end zone. They don't get it in, so they'll regret that. But flip it over, making a stand in that portion of the field, congratulations to them.